Alright, so today we're going to print circles, and I've got a whole giant collection of circles here, and you're going to be looking at the bottom of things, and these are just things that I've collected from around the house and around the classroom. So when we're doing it, you're going to want to use your hands and feel what it feels like. Like, this is smooth and that's bumpy, so that's going to have a bumpy pattern to it. So I've got this whole giant box, and we're looking at the circles, the bottoms of these bottles and some bobbins and pencil erasers and all kinds of things. And you're going to have a small collection of this larger collection at your table. Now see how that's flat and it goes in? So if you look at it from the side, you'll kind of get an idea of what it will print like. Alright, so you've got paper or styrofoam plates with some paint on it. And I'm going to give you some sketch paper because we're just going to make a sketch idea. And I want you to make one design. And you're developing a design, so if your first one doesn't work out, you can throw it out and try a different one. So I'm going to print it on there. Now see what happens is it doesn't print very well. I've got some gaps in that. Fix that by putting some fun foam underneath. Or you could put a whole lot of newspaper, but this fun foam gives it a little cushion. So now you're going to see how it's going to give me a little cushion. Now if you get too much paint on there, it won't make a nice print. So there's a Lego. That's circles too. I'm going to have a border around my circle design. We're making a radial design, a design that goes around. So you want to have a pattern, a design that goes around, because we are making a print pattern, first a radial pattern, and then later I'll show you how we're going to make a bigger pattern. Okay, I'm going to go fast as I show you how I develop my sketch. Alright, so last week we had our sketch idea, so now we've got our sketch idea, and again, what we're going to do is we're going to have our fun foam down as our base, and then you're going to have a piece of construction paper. Now, because we're going to be making a pattern, we're going to be making a repeating pattern of our radial pattern, we're going to fold our paper first in half, and then in half again, going one way, open it all the way back up, and then you're going to fold it in half long way, hot dog style, once. That way you will have 8 rectangles here. So we're going to do our pattern 8 times. So because you're working in a group, just print all of one object at once and then go through and print the other object all at once. And that way you'll be able to share better. Alright, I'm going to fast forward as I continue to show you how to do this. Alright, so remember, you dip and press, dip and press, dip and press. And to clean it off, you get a sponge, because you want to make sure that you don't leave that color for the rest of your table mates. And dip and press, dip and press. And some of these you have to push down pretty hard, like especially the spools. If you want that full pattern, you're going to have to really push into that fun foam. That's why I gave you the fun foam, so that you could push into the paper a little bit. Clean it off, clean it off. If your sponge gets too messy, go wash it in the sink. Alright, so here I'm actually going to print on the lines themselves to create that border, and like, I'm not going to be able to get it on the edge of that paper, so that's fine. I'm modifying my sketch just a little bit. That's okay. So I'm going to continue to use the Lego here to fill my border, and then the other Lego going the other way for all of the corners. And there it is, a printed pattern, both a radial pattern and a linear pattern.